Grass Valley is a small elementary school. We serve TK 5 in the East Oakland area of Oakland. What is unique about us is that we're actually located somewhat in the hills of Oakland. So we are a commuter school. Most of our students come from the flatlands, which is traditionally characterized as lower income area, and they commute to an area that is considered kind of middle upper class area. We also have a very high special education population at our school. I believe we are the highest at 25% special education. My name is Dr. Brandy Stewart. I am currently the principal of Grass Valley Elementary in Oakland Unified School District, and I have been an administrator in Oakland for 12 years.
So my name is Paula Mitchell, and I'm the teacher on special assignment at Grass Valley Elementary. My position, starting last year as a TSA, is with project-based learning and maker education, and also blended learning. So we're bringing a lot of hands-on things into the classroom.
I am helping develop the curriculum and then guiding the PLCs, so I'm facilitating the work that the teachers are doing. And I also push into classrooms to help with projects. The main reason is because we saw student engagement was kind of low, and we really believe that the way to get kids engaged and excited about their learning and actually take ownership of the learning is to do hands-on projects. And the philosophy of Maker Ed, it's like empowerment, make what you want to see in the world. You know, you can create what you want to do or see or be. And that's what we want to give students at that agency.
Last year we decided we would do maker-centered learning, and Paula Mitchell and I attended a institute that talked about making and thinking routines, which kind of sparked our interest, and it was something that Paula had already kind of done, had some background in.
Well, Maker was brought to me by one of our teachers at the time. I've tried to have a very collaborative and shared leadership model at our school, and teachers often come with ideas. And as a principal, have kind of always been on the search for this idea of like this engaging, culturally relevant way to serve kids. And when I went into Paula's classroom and saw and heard what she was talking about around maker education and the idea that students were producers of knowledge and that students would take kind of everyday skills and apply them in their lives and learn how to actually advocate and be empowered, I felt like this was kind of the missing piece I've been looking for kind of throughout my career, even as a teacher. And so I think that's where it began, was that being able to see something that I had always had a vision around in action in the classroom, it was like a natural next step in collaboration. So the way we have set up our model is one of the things that our TSA does is that she runs a weekly collaboration time that's an hour for whatever teachers are in a, we call them cohorts. So we have a group of four teachers who started last year as a cohort who plan projects together throughout the year. They met once a week for an hour, but then they also had additional like day-long plannings that were scheduled throughout the year or went to professional developments together. And our first cohort actually got a grant to go to summer planning together also. From what we learned from that cohort, we added a second cohort who also now meets for an hour once a week, and they're a newer cohort, so they're in the beginning stages of just learning how to collaborate, but we're using the same kind of processes that we've learned from our previous cohort and strategies to help them collaborate amongst each other.
I am the resource specialist here at Grass Valley Elementary. I am part of the pilot cohort for the project-based learning, and I have been working with this team for a couple of years now. We decided that we would like to do something different in education, and that we saw that we would try something art-based and project-based to get kids learning hands-on and really practicing their knowledge through kinesthetic work and visual work.
We reached out to a set of four teachers who were interested in kind of trying this new model, and they admit that they would have to change the culture of their classroom and then the way they were doing things. And when we found those four teachers, then we developed our schedule around them. And so part of it too was we set a long-term vision and then adjusted our resources, our schedule, our time to support that vision. So we are a smaller school, so we have less than 300 students, so we don't have a lot of funding. And so in order to create a maker space or fund our supplies or to go to professional developments, we do actually require support from others. And donations is basically right now one of the main ways that we're able to sustain this program. Collaboration is like the keystone for a successful school, is that we all have to consider all the students in the classrooms, not just our own individual classroom, but the entire school, our students, and expect that what's happening for one child in one classroom to be something that all students have access to. And that's really been our model too, in terms of embracing our special education programs and ensuring that their everyday experience and that their classroom experience mirrors that of our general education students. And so we purposefully create cohorts of teachers who collaborate around maker projects, which have special education and general education teachers together doing all of the planning, thinking about, well, what would this mean for a student who is on the autism spectrum.
Through this process, I'm seeing that the kids are really just growing. I'm seeing them express themselves in different ways. Through this making process, their thinking, creativity, bouncing ideas off of each other. So I'm learning from them as well as them learning from me.
Yeah, my students can prove through this work what they know. And it's not all, you know, in that traditional way. And we can show what kids learn through project-based. What can kids notice about their kind of place in the world? And then how can they push against that? And how can they demand more for themselves?
Expo is a culmination of actually tons of collaboration that happens throughout the year.
It is something that takes time, and you have to be willing to start over. You have to be willing to collaborate. You have to be willing to think outside of the box. Definitely you need time to do this, but overall I think it is so beneficial to the students. Like, my kids love making.